Good evening, friends. But it is too late to say good evening, so that we'll just finish off this very soon. And here are the experts for our nanotechnology and applications topic. Myself, Raju Nagbandi, and Samir, and Sudhir Koripalli, Pradeep Desham. And the agenda for today is, I'm not going to go through this one. Okay, what is nanotechnology? Nanotechnology is an emerging technology in today's world. And every nation is looking at this today in different ways. Nowadays, everyone is conducting research in these areas and try to improve in this field to make better in their technological levels. And the nanotechnology is all the, it says from the word nanotechnology, the technology involved in terms of nano. A nano is 1/1,000,000th of the meter, that is about 1/8,000th of the diameter of human hair, or 10 times the diameter of hydrogen atom. Top-down nanotechnology and bottom-up nanotechnology depends on two ways. It's a process for any manufacturing. It takes like two process, etching, wafer etching, and different types. So it involves in both ways. And the nanomaterials. The creation of functional material devices and systems through control of matter at a scale of 1 to 10 nanometers and exploration of novel properties and phenomena of the same scale. So the it all includes about the nanomaterials that we use. And if we take, for example, the nanometer size is as a 1/1,000th of the diameter of the hair, the width, and the impact of nanotechnology, we are not going to through any of this one. We are directly jumping to the video because of the time constraint. Let me go to the conclusion. Nanotechnology offers the ability to build large number of products that are incredibly powerful by today's standards. This possibility creates both opportunity and risk. The problem of minimizing the risk is not simple. Excessive restriction creates black markers, unrestricted nanofabrication. Selecting the proper level of restriction is likely to pose a difficult challenge. We have both the advantages and disadvantages of this nanotechnology. On the one hand, we can reduce the size of the product to nano size. And on the other hand, it also affects our health. In terms, the nanomaterials may pass into our blood cells, and it may cause some problems. So, and even if you are restricting the nanomaterials, the production of nanomaterials to down, there is a chance for the black market, and something might happen. We are not sure. So this is our conclusion. And if you have any questions.
Very good. Any questions?